डियर लर्नर, आई एम उमर फारूक महबूब पाशाली, लेक्चरर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम द ब्रह्मदेव दादामाने पॉलिटेक्निक सोलापुर. एक्चुअली दिस सेशन इज अ फोर्थ पार्ट ऑफ यूनिट टू टाइप्स ऑफ लैम्प इन द थर्ड ईयर सब्जेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग, दैट इज इल्यूमिनेशन एंड इलेक्ट्रिफिकेशन ऑफ बिल्डिंग. वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन थ्री सेक्शन, दैट इज थ्री पार्ट्स. देर इज अ डिफरेंट लैम्प. Today we also discuss the further lamps such as halogen lamp, types of tungsten halogen lamp, CFL lamp, comparison between the incandescent lamp and CFL lamp, metal halide lamp, LED lamp and laser lamp. These all points we are today teach from this session. First is the halogen lamp. We are discussing in that principle and construction of working. The figure shows the halogen lamp with there is a two end with the halogen filaments, tungsten support, high melting glass. The principle is that the amount of the radiation is visible spectrum increase the temperature of the incandescent material increases up to 6000 degrees Celsius. Therefore, any material will be suitable and will have a radiating efficiency which has high melting point. The base filament of this halogen lamp is the carbon and tungsten, because it has a melting point is near about 3500 degrees Celsius and 3400 degrees Celsius. So before we start this session, in that the halogen lamp is a lamp which is used in various section, and there is a lot of size and shapes, and there is a single ended halogen lamp also there and double ended halogen lamp also available. The carbon vapor very fast beyond its working temperature of 1800 degrees Celsius, so large electrical input is required to produce a given candle power. Thus the efficiency is low, about 3 lumens per watt. This is a drawback of that filament. The evaporation of carbon result into blinking of that inside of bulb. This phenomena is more occurred with their carbon and the tungsten employed the bulbs. In 1959, along with the argon gas filling, iodine was added, the drawback was eliminated. Therefore, the tungsten iodine, which is very volatile surface, thermal diffusion in the direction of the filament on the reaching the filament at high temperature, it's decomposed into the tungsten and halogen as therefore the function of a regenerative cycle is that it is necessary to maintain relative high bulb wall temperature of 250 degrees Celsius. So there will be iodine being a corrosive in nature, created problem during filling. So CH3Br was used, which was easy to fill. Non corrosive in nature and has less atomic weight that of iodine. There are two types of main voltage tungsten halogen lamp. One is a single ended halogen lamp and double ended halogen lamp. We can see here single ended halogen lamp, it has only one ended have a compact filament inside the which can be clearly visible. There is only one cap is fitted in double ended lamp. There is two ended, so double ended halogen lamp are tubular lamp with contact at each end. These contact are attached to short pin with their two seal point. The advantages of that halogen lamp is it is available in a miniature size. Single ended or double ended lamp, no blinking of lamp. It has higher lumens output up to the 22 to 33 lumen per watt, and it has operating temperature is high. It has and it's high longer life, about 2000 hours approximately. It's available in various sizes. The disadvantage is that the temperature under working condition is very high, bulb surface is sensitive, and not as a efficient as a high intensity discharge lamp. Application: these are used in public hall, factories, photo film, car lighting, large garden, airport runway, sports hall, and etc. Now, compact fluorescent lamp, that is CFL. Now condition, the CFL lamp is mostly used in every domestic line. So in that we are discussing the construction and working advantages and their disadvantages. Figure shows there the simple construction of CFL. The construction of CFL is that it is typical consist of the gas filled tube with their two electrodes mounted in a one end cap. It contained low pressure mix argon gas and mercury vapor, and liquid mercury is coated on inside of the three different phosphorus. Therefore, the flow of electrons is produced by an arc between two electrodes at the end of the tube. Then the blast provide the high initial voltage required to create the starting arc, and then limit the current to the prevent the lamp from self destruction. Now there are the advantages. It less heat produced in working condition, and the luminous efficiency is more, near about the 50 lumens per watt. Disadvantage, their cost is more and handling is precautionally, because if you are losing the CFL in from your hand, it will be directly damaged due to the glass coating. Next, we are discussing the comparison of the CFL with the incandescent lamp. The power consumption is more in incandescent lamp, but CFL less 20% to 30%. Life 2000 incandescent lamp, but 800 hours for the CFL. Energy efficiency is 15 lumen per watt, but the CFL it 50 lumens per watt. After that, lost. There are the losses in that very less, but 3 to 10 times is more. After that, life, uses residential indoor lighting. It will use residential and the commercial lighting. Next lamp is a metal halide lamp. This lamp is known as a mercury halide or metal halide lamp. because it has a short arc tube. So inside it there is a series of lamp combined within a single arc tube with the output characteristics of different mixture of elements. Okay, so in that we are discussing the construction and working, advantages, disadvantages and uses. In that we are taking two figures. In that one figure is a metal halide lamp and second one is a control circuit system. So in that, when such metals like thallium, indium, sodium are introduced into the mercury arc tube, the mercury spectrum is suspended, reducing the ultraviolet radiation, but added the metal atoms partly compensated by the causing a wider range of the spectral bond to be emitted. It will produce white or green light if the metals are used in element from the attack the discharge tube. To avoid the metal in element form, its halide is used like iodide, that is sodium iodide. The lamp require high starting voltage. Figure A shows, this is controlling system, that is control circuit with ignition for the metal halide lamp. Igniter is connected across the lamp terminal. These types of starter we call as a starter enable the lamp to the restart within the minute of a beginning of switched off. Now there is advantages. Good for high ceiling indoor lighting. Next, more poor white light is obtained. Next, more energy efficient than the mercury lamp or halogen lamp. Next, there is disadvantages. Cost is more. Second, produce more light pollution. Uses, that is application, used for high bay interior and high mast exterior installation, that is it is mostly used in sports stadium and floor lighting projector. Now discuss the lamp, that is LED light emitting diode. Figure shows the light emitting diode lamp. The lamp the gallium arsenide junction based in the forward direction was found to be an efficient emitter of the radiation. The PN junction are similar to the conventional silicon and germanium diode so far as electrical characteristics are concerned. However, when biased in the forward direction, some of the energy dissipated is converted into the light rather than into the resistive heating, hence called as a semiconductor lamp. LED is a similar electrical characteristic as the normal rectifying diode have. LED are the virtually point source of the high intensity radiation. Life of LED's device is very long and these are mechanically robust, low current consuming. There are the advantages: low power consumption, long life, it's starting quickly, less self heating, small in size and weight, more energy sufficient, no damage due to the external shock, etc. Disadvantages: stable voltage source is required, initial cost is more, life is affected due to the voltage fluctuation. There are the applications: indicating lamps, bicolor indicator, fault indicator, display board, decorative lighting, in instrumentation, etc. Now the next lamp is special lamp, that is a laser lamp. We are discussing the construction and working, advantages, disadvantages and their applications. Laser means light amplification by the simulated emission of radiation. Laser means light amplification by simulated emission of radiation. Consider an item when external energy is applied to the to its electron jumps from the lower energy state to high energy state. This electron emits the electromagnetic radiation and light. The color of light depend on a frequency and wavelength. Therefore, the energy released is known as a photon energy. This process is called as absorption. After the short time, the electron again goes to previous lower energy state, emitting photons in the process. This known as a spontaneous emission. If the photon passes near this electron, it causes the electron to be decay. Under the desired condition, if item undergoes simulated emission, the item releases more photon. This action is cumulative and the chain reaction is formed, which is release lot of photons. The figure shows the arrangement for producing the laser light energy. It consists of the external source in the form of flashing light source, two mirror and laser rod. The reflecting mirror has a high reflecting capacity, the other mirror has less reflectivity. The external source is in the form of flashing light. When the light flash on the laser rod, that time emission takes place, therefore the photons travels back and the forth due to the mirror. Therefore, the amplification takes place. When the energy released is greater than certain limit, laser light come out in the form of the sharp beam. This laser beam come out from the partially reflecting mirror. There are many types of laser. These are stated below: gas laser, liquid laser, chemical laser, X-ray lasers, semiconductor laser, optical pumped solid state laser. Now there is advantages. Laser beam travel long distance. It can be used for the beautification. It can be used in medical equipment. It can be used in metal processing industries. Next, there is a disadvantage. Operating equipment, control gear is required. Cost is more. High intensity. Strict safety precaution are necessary. Last is applications. Special light effect required for the media work. After that, medical field, and laser beam arrangement is used in CD drive of the computer for reading or writing the data on a CD. Thank you so much.